I'm Ganesh Anand, and I'm an associate professor in the Department of Biological Sciences at the National University of Singapore. I'm also a director of the proteomics core facility at the department there. The core facility we run is the proteomics facility, and it complements two other facilities we have on our campus, one on focusing on lipidomics and one on metabolomics. So the proteomics core facility, the two focus areas we have are quantitative proteomics, looking at cancer biomarkers and their discovery, looking at complex ID of proteins and complex mixtures, and structural mass spectrometry with deuterium exchange mass spectrometry. We have a total of five instruments in our core facility, two of which are from Waters, the Synapt G1 and the Synapt G2SI. We got very interested in studying how viruses are, you know, these dynamic entities that are breathing in solution. And more importantly, how do they sense a change in environment? How do they know whether they're in a mosquito or when they hit the human host? So the human host is at 37 degrees. And so what electron microscopy had shown was that viruses are compact at low temperatures. When they hit the human host, they expand. In that's something similar to a kid's toy called the Hoberman sphere. So the expanded form is what we wanted to study, because that's the basis for the infectious phase of the virus infection. And so we wanted to use deuterium exchange to capture where on the virus these opening up movements occur. And so that's how we got started on this. The Waters system that we have is a G2SI that comes with a chiller module. So it's a very complete system, which allows us to temperature control the deuterium exchange experiment. So it's really finely programmed. It's a great piece of engineering. And it has also really good processing software alongside. So it gives a one-stop solution for doing these experiments. But and the most critical thing for the virus studies was the sensitivity of the instrument. It was really important to have a very sensitive instrument, because our virus titers cannot be really high. It can't be compared to other proteins you may work with. So having a very high sensitivity instrument was key, and we were able to really test that. So having our new G2SI from Waters, Synapt G2SI, was really critical for the virus work. I think deuterium exchange has grown in leaps and bounds. It's really exploded in the last couple of years. And I think it's going to be incorporated with top-down mass spectrometry, with ion mobility, as well as more of the localization with ETD. These are all new breakthroughs in how to process deuterium exchange data. And I think so. And then computational modeling. All of these things are going to emerge as a completely new structural mass spectrometry field. And there's no limit to the size of particles that you can start to look at, biological molecules. You can start to look at bigger and bigger complexes, such as viruses, organelles, suborganelle particles. So I think we can start to look at a more holistic view of how molecules work inside cells.